the new cut to size package export, perfect when you're creating either a requisition or a purchase order for cut to size parts. It's a simple export, and it creates a package which includes the NC files and the drawings for just the parts you need. And what this enables us to do is provide our service centres with just the files that they need. A lot of service centres now have software which can interpret the NC files directly and draw that information out. So we're not just sending them a material list of parts that we need. We're sending them intelligent information which allows them to quote and produce these parts in the most efficient manner. The main benefits of this export, which may probably be obvious, but we're able to save time and eliminate errors. The current process today for most fabricators for cut to size orders is they'll go through a whole long list of NC files and drawings that have been produced by the modelling software, and hand pick the files that they need, which is open to lots of room for error. You may select the wrong file, you may miss files. And all sorts. Secondly to that, as part of our export, we actually modify the quantity of parts within inside the NC files to reflect the quantity that you actually want to order at any given time. So the NC file that your service centre will receive is for the correct part as per your order or your requisition, not the overall part quantity on the job. And as I mentioned a few moments ago, we've added this at both the quote and order stage. So you can do this export from either the requisition screen or the purchase order screen, which just makes the interface easier to use. And we have that added level of continuity. So if I go back into Tekla EPM and I open up a production control job, on this job, I'm going to say that all of my plates on lot one need to be ordered cut to size from my service center or my vendor, whoever it may be. So as I would do normally, I come to production control purchasing, and then depending if I need to go out for pricing for these parts or whether I know who's going to be providing them, I can either do it from a requisition or a purchase order. The functionality is the same, but I'm going to go into a requisition, and I already have a requisition pre-prepared. So I'm just going to do a quick filter for just my plates on lot number one. Okay, I'll import those. And as you would do normally, if you open up that requisition, you will see a list of all those parts within the requisition. So the new feature lies within the requisition and export files. And as you can see here, you can choose to export just the NC files, just the drawings, or both the NC files and the drawings for either the selected rows or the displayed parts. So I'll choose that one there. I will just shorten the file name ever so slightly. It will warn me if any of the NC files are missing. So in this case, I've got one part that doesn't have an NC file, and it would do likewise with the drawings. Just on that note, if a part drawing is missing, it will default back to the assembly drawing in its place, just so you're aware of that. So that's created a zip file. If I just open up that zip package, and as you can see, we have now the NC files and the part drawings, or if it doesn't exist, the associated assembly drawing for just the parts that I want to order cut to size. The system's done that for me automatically. I've not had to go through huge long lists of NC files and drawings and had to pick out the files I need for this particular requisition or purchase order. So that's one huge time saver there. The second thing that's of real significance is that the quantity within the NC files will be updated to reflect the quantity you actually want to order as part of this particular requisition. So as an example, if I open up part F1001, you will see that the quantity there, or the amount field, is 4. And that's been amended from the overall part quantity that would have been on the original NC file out of the CAD system. So to demonstrate this, I'll close this down for a second, and I will just filter my requisition for that part number, just to make it a bit easier to see. So we can see on there that this particular part, I only need four of those. However, if I go back to the production control job and do a filter for the same part, you can see that I have 11 of these in total, four of which are on lot number one, and they're the four that I've added onto the requisition. And then there's a further seven which are on lot two, which at this stage I don't want to order. However, if you had just sent your service center the NC file for straight out of the CAD system, if I demonstrate that here with F1001, if I open that up, you can see that the original NC file has a quantity of 11. So the risk you run by doing it the old way is that you may either get quoted for more than you require, or you may actually end up paying and being sent more than you require. So there's another real benefit to using the export out of Tekla EPM for your NC files and your fabrication drawings. And obviously at this stage, you could send your service entry or supplier that package of files, and they can either use that to quote or ultimately produce those parts for you.